Hi everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to study about trigeminal neuralgia. Now, trigeminal neuralgia is a rare condition, but again, it is not something we can't come across when we are doing in our clinical practices. So, moving ahead with what is the introduction of the trigeminal neuralgia. See, it is the most debilitating form of neuralgia that affects the sensory branches of the fifth cranial nerve. Okay, so I want you all to write the name of the fifth cranial nerve in the comments section. It is a disorder of the peripheral or the central fibers of trigeminal nerve in which dominant symptom is pain in the anterior half of the head. So this is the main feature to be kept in mind when a patient comes with you with a complaint that he is having pain particularly in anterior half of the head. So this is the most dominant symptom we'll get. Okay, so most of the time this condition is going to reflect your trigeminal neuralgia. Moving ahead, if we see the proper definition, it is defined as a sudden, usually unilateral, that means on one side of the face, severe, brief, that is the duration of period is going to be very, very less for just some seconds, and stabbing, lancinating, reoccurring pain in the distribution of one or more branches of the fifth cranial nerve. So let me know the name of the fifth cranial nerve in the comment section. Also, you must be knowing that this particular nerve has three branches, the ophthalmic branch, maxillary and the mandibular branch, right? So this is when one or two or more branches of are getting pain and there is a reoccurring pain in the branches of this nerve, that is said to be a trigeminal neuralgia. So if we come to the historical review of the trigeminal neuralgia, it was first introduced by John Locke in 1677. He gave the first full description about this disease with its treatment. Then Nicholas Andre in 1756 coined the term tic dolor ex. Now, what do you mean by tic dolor ex? This basically means painful jerks. Okay, what do you mean by this? It means painful jerks. So, when the patient is suffering from trigeminal neuralgia, he's going to have painful jerking, and the pain is so severe, it is so disturbing that even if the wind is passing by, the pain can occur, and it is a very painful condition. You know, this condition is so painful that sometimes the patient feels like committing a suicide. He thinks that, handling pain is more difficult than doing suicide. So sometimes suicidal attacks could also be there in this disease. Another very important point is, John Fothergill in 1773 published detailed description about the trigeminal neuralgia. Also, that is the reason it is known to be as the Fothergill's disease. Okay, the other name from trigeminal neuralgia is the Fothergill's disease. Why? Because he gave the detailed description about the disorder. Now, as I told you, tic dolor ex means painful jerking of the body or of the face particularly. It is a truly agonizing condition in which the patient may clutch the hand over the face and experience severe lancinating pain associated with spasmodic contraction of the facial muscles during the contact or the attack. Now, what are the particular etiology which could be responsible? See, there could be a number of etiologies. Some etiological reasons could be as simple as blowing of the wind or maybe whistling or maybe laughing or smiling could be some of the reasons. So, they are some of the main reasons that could be etiological factor. Other than that, demyelination of the nerves, multiple sclerosis, Petrus ridge compression, post-traumatic neuralgia, intracranial tumors, and at times the reason could be diabetes mellitus also. So these are some of the etiological factors we come across. Now coming to the pathogenesis. See, with pathogenesis is something you need to know here is that with time, the condition here is going to get severe, okay? In starting, maybe the episodes of attack was occurring in 4 months, then it started to occur in the gap of 2 months, then 1 month, then in few weeks, and then maybe on daily basis the patient is facing the attacks, which is an extremely severe condition. So what happens is, you see the red color here is these periods of exacerbation and periods of remission. So you see in the early condition there is very less attack that is occurring, okay? The time or the period of attacks is very less. With time, this period is going to increase, and in the later disease course, it becomes so severe that the attacks will occur on a very regular and short interval of time, due to which it becomes very painful and life-threatening. No, life-threatening as in a case, because the patient starts feeling that instead of handling this pain, I should commit a suicide. So that is the reason we can say it to be a life-threatening condition. Other than that, there is no threat to life which occurs. Moving ahead to some general characteristics to be kept in mind. See, as I told you, it is a very rare condition. So you can see the incidence are so less. Age usually is the fifth and sixth decade of life. Gender predilection, females of course are little more affected than males. Affliction of the side, see, right side are more affected than the left side. And then we talk about the division of the trigeminal nerve. I told you that there are three parts or three branches of the trigeminal nerve. So the mandibular branch is going to be most affected, ophthalmic to be least affected. Okay, this is how it occurs. Moving ahead to some clinical characteristics. See, as I told you, you have to keep this on your tips that it is a very sudden, unilateral, intermittent, paroxysmal, sharp and shooting pain. It is a very shocking and a shooting pain. The patient becomes very, very disturbed with even some seconds. It is going to last for 5 seconds, and that 5 seconds will be the most difficult seconds, okay? So shock-like pain electing by slight touching, superficial trigger points which radiates from that point across the distribution of all the three branches. So even if you slightly touch that particular branch area, the pain will start triggering. Pain is usually confined to one part of the division of the trigeminal nerve. So whichever branch has been affected, the pain will be, confined to that particular area only. Pain rarely crosses the midline, and so we say that it is unilateral. So if this is the right side and this is the left side of face, the right side is more prominently affected. Attacks does not occur during the sleeping time. Pain is short duration but can occur with variable frequency. In extreme cases, the patient will have motionless face or frozen or a mask-like face because all the sensations will be lost at this particular moment. Now, what are the common trigger zones? See, the common trigger zones could be the corner of the lips, cheek, ala of the nose or the lateral brow. In the intraoral structures, we see the common sites to be teeth, gingiva and the tongue. Moving, how you can diagnose the particular condition. A well taken history is something you can go for. Another thing is you can go for MRI also. So if you know the full form of MRI, do let me know in the comment section. Okay. Now we have diagnostic nerve block. Now what do you mean by this diagnostic nerve block is, what we do is, we ask the patient to sit there and then we inject. Two conditions are going to happen. See, first thing that actually the pain is happening to the patient. Another thing could be it is a psychological issue that is happening with the patient. Since psychological, how we are going to determine that is it a psychological pain or an actual pain? What we do is we will take distilled water, okay? And after when we take distilled water, no, we will inject this distilled water in one of the branches in which the patient is telling the pain. If the pain is relieved after giving distilled water injection, that means it was just psychological. So patient was not actually having very threatening pain. So because pain can never be relieved by a distilled water. So if he says that okay with distilled water, usko to nahi pata that you are giving distilled water, right? So if the pain is relieved with distilled water, that means it is something psychological and no actual condition is there. But for example, the pain is not relieved by distilled water, then we give LA to the patient in the particular branch. And now when the pain is relieved after giving LA, that means now that is actually a diagnostic. That a diagnosis is there that okay, the patient was actually having a pain and was not just making it up, right? So when the pain is relieved with LA, that means it is actually a case of pain, and when it is being relieved by distilled water, that means it is just a psychological condition. Now the treatment modalities again could be medicative or surgery. Now medical management could be carbamazepine, okay? Now these are basically the dosage and some brand names you could see. Side effects of this is visual blurring, dizziness, skin rashes that could happen. Phenytoin could be another example. It is usually used in conjunction with carbamazepine. Again, you can see the dosage is 200 to 600 mg per day. So you can also remember the name. That is enough. Moving ahead, we have gabapentin. Then we move ahead to baclofen. Now we come to surgical management. Peripheral injections are one of the surgical management which could be done, okay? So it has been the known as injection of destructive substance into peripheral branches of trigeminal nerve produces anesthesia effect in the trigger zones and distribution of the spontaneous pain. So when we give injections to the peripheral branches of the trigeminal nerve, it produces an anesthetic effect due to which the pain is actually relieved, okay? Now adrenaline such as bupivacaine and without corticosteroids, with or without corticosteroids could be given to the patient. It is going to give an anesthetic effect to the patient. So this was all about trigeminal neuralgia. If this video was useful to you, please let me know in the comments section. Also suggest me some new topics. Like the video, share this with your friends, and of course let me know the answers I asked you in this video in the comment section. Thank you so much.